Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to be doing a brief overview of this tank radio receiver. I bought this at a flea market for around 45 bucks, and from the research that I've done, it's post-World War II, and it looks like we have a date here, September 1955. This is just a receiver, not a transceiver, and guy said it worked when I picked it up, however, it doesn't. With the help of some fellow hams, I'm able to figure out they pop it open with this one screw in the back. I was trying to take out the faceplate and take it all apart from the front, but that didn't really work. But one screw, quarter turn, and then the whole thing just pulls out. So once we figured out how to get that open, me and my buddy found a burnout vacuum tube. It was the 6V6 audio amplifier tube. So we bought a used one off of eBay and plugged it in, and sure enough, and now it makes noise. So let's go ahead and turn it on. And you can listen to the noises it makes. Now, from the research I've done, it seems to be a low band AM radio. And you can see we have our indicator glowing. The squelch is off and sensitivity is all the way up. So I would assume that you would plug an antenna into here. We have the letters A and G. G perhaps for ground and A for antenna. I don't know 100%. Looks like you could put some ladder line in there. So you can switch from tuning to actual operation to tune. Press and hold this button and use the tuning knob. And there you have the gauge. So it is in megacycles, also known as megahertz. And looks like we're passing 50 and 25. I'm not sure what the differences between the two numbers, but 24, 23, and so on and so forth. And then what's also a neat feature, and I'll show you this in a couple minutes, is the ability to go to preset channels by pushing these buttons up here. And let's get a shot of the dial moving. And you can see it jumps to whatever you punch in. And it works quite well. It's all mechanical. There's nothing electronic to it when it comes to the channel switching feature. And it's really something else. So let's go ahead and take it apart and I'll show you the insides. So here you can see the one side. I'm not going to touch anything because it was just turned on and we might have some residual voltage. But we have the moisture treatment tag. That's what all this yellow stuff is. And looks like first month of 1945 this treatment was applied, so perhaps this faceplate is from a newer radio then that was then stuck onto this unit. But I mean, you can see everything's in beautiful condition, no rust, nothing corroded or exploded, and it's all pretty much there. So then on this side you can see we have the mechanical channel mechanism, and we have the vacuum tubes down here. Here's the 6V6 that was blown out, and just ordered that right off of eBay, replaced it, and it's good to go. So there's really not a whole lot to it. It's pretty simple compared to modern radios. Not a whole lot of circuitry. We got a connector on the back. Not sure what type this is. If you know what type it is, please leave it in the comments down below. That'd be very much appreciated. And normally this radio would run off of whatever voltage the tank was running at, but somebody retrofitted it with this little power supply unit. It's this aluminum block and the transformer, I would presume, up here. So now you can run it off of alternate voltage. And then let's go back around to the front. So you remember the channel switching mechanism. Now this is really neat when you go to hit a channel. Let's get a close-up of that, because you can see you got this entire mechanism mechanically operated that is switching your channels for you. And everything is linked together with springs and gears. And it's amazing what they were able to do back in the day without integrated circuits and relays and stuff like that. I mean, this is crazy. The amount of machining and precision that went into making this device. So, that's about all for today. I just figured I'd put this up on the YouTube for people to see and enjoy. And if you worked on these radios back in the day when you were serving, or if you got a radio, or if you're a ham and you know something about this, please leave it in the comments down below. I'm looking for any and all information on these radios. I'm wondering if I can hook an antenna up to here. I haven't given it a try yet, but I definitely will in the near future. And, yeah, leave any questions, comments, concerns in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. That's all for today. Work hard and stay humble.